You are watching Oklahoma Burning, continuous coverage of a very large grass and wildfire that is affecting the area of Jones and Spencer. Folks are having a tough time. They're having to do some evacuations tonight. And crews just trying to get it under control.
Homes have burned. Outbuildings have burned at least 600 to 700 acres as well. As we're about to show you some of the pictures from the scene, this is Sky 5 Live showing you one of the water drops by a National Guard Black Hawk helicopter. We want to also bring in Rusty Surette with the American Red Cross. And Rusty, we know that you guys have opened a shelter. Are you finding that people are going to the First United Methodist Church to get some food and drink and just kind of take a break?
Yeah, Jessica, we're actually going to be opening that here within the next 45 minutes, and we welcome anyone who has been affected by this fire. This is such a heartbreaking scene out here. So we're going to be out here again at the First United Methodist Church in Jones, welcoming anyone who's been impacted by these wildfires in the Spencer and Jones area. And if their homes have gone up in flames, we will be there to make sure that they are getting whatever immediate needs they have. And that includes shelter, food, clothes, emotional support. We are certainly there for them and the first responders who are working real hard out here this evening.
So, Rusty, so you're going to open up just around 7 o'clock then? And also, how long do you anticipate having the shelter open? Does it just depend on once you get those doors open, the need that you see, if you're going to continue to keep it open through the overnight hours?
Absolutely. We'll take a look at what people need. If we end up finding that there are a number of families who have no place to go, they don't have any family or friends to turn to or extra space, we'll keep that shelter open overnight. We will, again, open it up at about 6:45 or 7, and we welcome anyone to come by if they need food or water or just someone to talk to or a place to sit and rest and gather their thoughts. This is a horrible thing for people to go through. So we're going to open up that place. It's near the evacuation area, and we'll be there for anyone who needs our help. And we're certainly out here helping the hardworking police and firefighters too.
Rusty, these are incredible efforts that happen very quickly. The church and all of that sort of thing, you guys are able to lay all of this out. Are crews just ready all the time at the Red Cross? Is that how all of this is happening so quickly?
I always say we're a lot like first responders. We're on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We are ready to go. We knew that the wildfire threat was here, so we were certainly paying attention to the reports that you all were giving, and Channel 5 was giving some great information, and we were paying attention. So we're ready to go at a moment's notice, and we're going to be out here. And if anybody is sitting at home wanting to help, how you're asking, how can you help your neighbors in this situation? We urge anyone to please give to the Red Cross and the disaster relief. We rely 100% on donations, and we can do this job because of the money that we get from our donors. So please give and help out your neighbors tonight.
All right. Okay. And also all of those volunteers who are out there.
Rusty,
tonight.
We appreciate it. And, you know, the Red Cross is out there not only setting up the shelter, they provide water to the crews on the scene. You're talking about the firefighters, any of the first responders that are out there, they are helping them out.